In this video, we will explain what preloading is and show how to do it in survey solutions. Preloading, in the simplest terms, involves filling in the answers to interview questions before the interview even starts, using information you already know about your sample. The two most common uses for preloading are 1. To load the list of household members, plots, or enterprises that was established during an earlier interview. 2. To load information from earlier interviews to check the accuracy or plausibility of information collected during the current interview. Let's discuss how to preload data in survey solutions. To make this otherwise abstract discussion more concrete, we will use an example throughout this video. In this tutorial, we will use an example of a household survey that consists of questions at the household level and a roster at the household member level. The questionnaire template used in this tutorial can be found in the list of public questionnaires in Questionnaire Designer. It is named Preloading Tutorial. You can copy the questionnaire and follow along. Suppose you want to preload information about household members and verify that the gender from 2010 matches the gender now. To use preloading to verify information collected in a current interview, first copy the gender question. Define a variable name for the copied question. We will use a suffix, underscore 2010, to indicate that a variable comes from the 2010 round of the survey. Change the question scope to hidden. Hidden questions are useful to store preloaded data that you do not want the interviewer to be able to change. Next, add a validation condition to the interview question that checks if the current survey data entry is the same as the answer that will be preloaded in the hidden question. Survey Solutions expects preloaded data to have a certain structure, format, and content. Let's explore each requirement in turn. Survey Solutions has one data set for each level of observations in a questionnaire. To see what this means, recall that our example survey consists of questions at the household level and a roster at the household member level. Because Survey Solutions has one data set for each level of observation, the data sets for this questionnaire would consist of two files, one containing data from questions at the household level, another with data set for questions at the member level. Survey Solutions expects data to follow a certain format. First, the data files must be in tab delimited format. You can create this file either with any spreadsheet program or with a statistical software package. Most spreadsheet programs can save files to tab delimited file format, such as Excel to .txt, Google Sheets, and LibreOffice to .tsv. Statistical software packages typically provide some command to save data to tab delimited, such as data's outsheet command or other file saving options in SPSS and R. File names must match the name of the section of the questionnaire to which they are linked. For files with data at the household level, the file name matches the questionnaire name. For files that map to nested rosters, the file name must match the name of that nested roster to which they should be linked. Each individual file is composed of an ID, potentially a parent ID, and other variables. The ID is a unique identifier for each observation in a dataset. For example, the ID uniquely identifies households in a household-level dataset, or household members in a given household within a member-level dataset. The parent ID is an identifier that links each child item to its respective parent item. For example, the parent ID in a household member level dataset would be the household to which each member belongs. The other variables in the dataset must follow the rules set out for them in Designer. Variable names in the data files must match variable names in the questionnaire. Data must follow the format and validation rules for the destination variables in the questionnaire. If a question is numeric, its preloaded data must be numeric. If a question's range is restricted by policy validation rules, the range of its preloaded data must be as well. Now that we have discussed data preparation, we will demonstrate how you can upload data. Survey Solutions has a built-in feature which provides a set of data files that allows you to preview how the dataset must look. To download those data files, click on the Survey Setup tab at the top of the page. Then, click on the Questionnaire and select the Batch Upload button. Next, under the Pre-filled and Collected Data heading, click on the download.zip template for this questionnaire link. The zip file we downloaded for the sample questionnaire consists of two tab-delimited files, one that contains the parent ID and the questions at the household level of observation, and another file that contains the questions in the household members roster. We will now walk you through a step-by-step example to fill out the data files properly. Suppose you want to create four survey cases, that is, four household interviews, and you would like to fill out the address and household members' information from 2010. To do this, start with the tab-delimited file for the household level of observation. The ID column in this file is the ID for each survey case. This ID could be any arbitrary unique number, such as household ID. We assign numbers 1 through 4 here. Then, complete the head of household and address variable information. Next, fill in the household members list question with data collected from a previous visit. Note that each row in this tab-delimited file represents one household. The final step is to save the file as tab-delimited. To do this in Excel, select Save As from the File tab. Then, select tab-delimited as the file format and click Save. We will now complete the tab-delimited file for the household roster. The first column, ID, must be filled out with consecutive unique numbers for each household member. For list rosters, the counting will begin with the number 1. For numeric rosters, the counting for ID will begin with the number 0. For rosters with a fixed set of items, the ID should match the code of the item in Designer. For example, suppose the first household has 3 members, and the second household has 4 members. You will enter the numbers 1 through 3 and then follow with 1 through 4 for the second household. Note that you do not need to fill out all of the variables in the preloading file. Anything that is not filled out will be blank on the tablet. Complete the household members question with the name of each household member listed in the roster source question in the first tab-delimited file. Then, in the parent ID column, enter the household ID number for each individual. This number should be the same as the ID number assigned to each household in the first tab-delimited file. This is similar to the structure of member-level data from a household survey where each member record has both a household and person ID. However, in Survey Solutions, the household ID becomes the parent ID and the person ID the ID variable. As previously explained, save the file as tab-delimited and compile all the tab-delimited files in a zip file. Next, upload the zip file using the green Upload Zip File button under the Pre-filled and Collected Data heading. The headquarters software will confirm that the uploaded tab-delimited file contains valid contents and follows the format that the headquarters software expects. If the data does not have any errors, then the headquarters software will create the interviews with the preloaded data. Once this step has been completed, supervisors can log into their accounts and assign the survey cases to the interviewers in their data collection team. After interviewers synchronize, the survey cases assigned to them will appear on their tablet's dashboard. As shown, the data that has been preloaded will display in the questionnaire. The questionnaire template used in this tutorial can be viewed under the Public Questionnaires tab in Questionnaire Designer. It is named Preloading Tutorial.